so just bear with me for like an hour, okay? This next song that I'm gonna do for you, that I'm gonna sort of leave you with, it changed my life, this song, when I wrote it, let alone what ended up happening with the song itself. But I know I've been joking about it a bit throughout the show, but that relationship when I was 21, the one that the 21 album's about, you know, was a very intense and a very important relationship and time in my life. And I always play the bitch and the witch, but actually it was a fantastic relationship at times. And at the point when I wrote this song, again, I'm sure you're aware of this, but I couldn't have been more miserable if I tried. It was a real, you know, down point for me, and probably to date the worst part of my life so far. And I was left. I was the one that was left, and I'm sure that anyone else in the room that has experienced being left, when someone leaves you and you don't really know why, because they're not quite man enough or woman enough to tell you why, you can't work out what it is that's wrong with you, and you convince yourself that no one is ever going to want you again, and you kind of reside to the fact that you might be on your own forever. And I didn't want to be on my own forever. I wanted to meet someone again, and I didn't know what was wrong with me. So, you know, it was an incredibly low time for me, and I already had written probably 4 or 5 songs for the 21 record. So it wasn't like I'd suddenly had this feeling or the relationship had suddenly broken down and I wrote this song. It was, you know, a few months into the breakup. And one day I'd had enough of feeling so lonely. I was so lonely it gave me tummy aches, you know, it was horrible. And one day I was like, I'm going to start owning myself again, and he can't write a song, so I'm going to write a song. And this is the only time it had ever happened that I, you know, sat down with a purpose to specifically write a song, and it had happened. Any time I'd ever tried before, nothing had happened. Any time ever since, nothing had ever happened. And this one day, the stars, they just aligned for me. Within a couple of hours, I had the first verse and the chorus of this song. And I felt fantastic about myself. I felt at peace with my situation. And I was kind of excited about what might happen, you know, next with my life. At this point, it had nothing really to do with the song and the fact that I was writing it for my second record and stuff like that. And I originally wrote this song on guitar, but it wasn't quite heartbreaking enough, so we transposed it to piano, just to make it a little bit more unbearable. And I remember playing this song to like my manager, my mum, and my best friend. And they all reacted in a very, very different way than they had to any of the other songs. But more importantly, I reacted a very different way to this song, and it is a very, very sad song, and don't get me wrong, I'm aware of that, but the sentiment is with fondness. It's like letting someone go with peace and with being grateful, you know, for the time that I did have. And when you break up, you know, whether it be by choice or not, it does feel a little bit like a death, and it's quite hard, because I don't know about, I can't be friends with my ex-boyfriends, fuck no, no way, no chance at hell. That's never gonna happen, you know, and you have to learn to live again, you know, live again on your own. And that this song gave me my freedom is how I felt. And then I sang this song about 5.5 years ago now, on a stage very, very similar to this in England, that our sort of equivalent of your Grammys, called the Brit Awards. And I sang it, and then I flew to New York straight after. So within that sort of 7-8 hour flight, my life changed 360, and it has never ever been the same ever since. And amazing things change, incredible things change, bizarre things change that I will never get my head around. And I know that sometimes I come across like I don't like what comes with what I do. And I'll be honest with you, sometimes I really, really don't. The reason I'm so fierce about my privacy is because I want to be able to live a very normal and real life, so I can write a real record for real people. That's what I can do. And I don't want to get carried away with myself, because I've met people that get carried away with themselves and I don't like them, I don't like them, and I don't want to be one of those people. So again, thank you for your patience for while I took so long to move my whole life. And thank you for being so kind to me when I came back. I will go away again, but I will come back again at some point as well. I have no idea what music will be. But thank you for coming to my show. Thank you for being an incredible audience. And thank you for your love, just in general, right? This is Someone Like You for you. Let's sing along. Wow, this will be 20,000 desperados. She gave her things. Turn up out of the blue, uninvited, but I couldn't stay away. I couldn't fight it. I hope you see my face, that you'd be reminded that for me it isn't over. That you'd be reminded that for me it isn't over yet. I heard you from the first time, you sing it for me.
Sometimes it hurts and stays.